G'day guys, back again. Hope you're all doing well. Just another look at another cool sci-fi kit from the past. And look guys, I'm going to admit to you that I was never really a big fan of this model. It just didn't really appeal to me. But to tell you the truth, I think I was sort of looking at some other sci-fi kits at the same time. Only recently, when I saw a couple of videos of this model built up online, and I thought, gee willikers, it's a nice looking model. Now look, I don't know, I haven't built it, so I'm not saying that it's absolutely fantastic model to build, but some of the models that I've seen built up on YouTube just look fantastic, especially the amount of detail in these engines here. They just look amazing. So I'll put a couple of links to a couple of the videos that I've watched on YouTube. I wish they sold these separately, these engines. I mean, for someone who's wanting to there's on Facebook, there's a, I think, kit bashing, that's what I was looking for, a kit bashing sci-fi Facebook page, and some of the guys on that, you know, with all the shampoo bottles and just stuff you have lying around your house, all the bottles that you throw in the bin, the stuff that they're building with those things and, you know, gluing them together and then adding parts, like, you know, they used to do in the Star Wars movies, whack a couple of parts of Tamiya kits on here and there and all that, and wham, you know, you've got an AT-ST or a AT-AT or Millennium Falcon, who knows, but you know what? These parts can be used for 100 million different things. Anyway, that's why I got excited about this kit. Damn you, YouTube. Damn you. Now, I'll show you on the side of the box here. Bloody lights always in the way, in the wrong spot. Sorry, guys. I don't have a... Studio staff's gone off due to the virus. All my 27 staff that I've got, I've had to ask them to take leave. So my YouTube channel is going to run as good as it has been in the past. Just jokes, guys. Just jokes. I haven't put anyone off. I don't have anyone to put off. But anyway, look at this. Here's the built-up models. And like I said, look, guys, you know my channel. I just like showing things on my channel that, you know, maybe one day someone's crossing my channel, obviously by accident, judging by the amount of subscribers I've got. And, yeah, they think, oh, that's pretty cool, which is why I'm putting some links below. But anyway, I thought I'd just show you the instructions. Look, can you make the instructions any bigger? Gee willikers, look at the size of this thing. Oh my god, is it a map? Where am I going, somewhere? Holy guys, I mean, seriously, like, you know, last time I looked at an instruction sheet this big, you know, was to try and find the G-spot. I mean, for god's sakes, that's the first page. Which is pretty boring, really, other than the picture at the front. So I'm going to zoom in, guys, because this is just too big. It's too much work, just like the G-spot. It's too much work. All right. So there's step one there. Pretty basic. I could do that part with some help. Two and three. Now, some of the videos I've seen... with these people doing, look, what do you call this sort of stuff? You know, the front stuff. I'm going to call it the dashboard. That's the sideboard, but the dashboard at the front. Some of the stuff that guys have been doing and painting these things, I mean, it just looks fantastic. Now, when I saw the pilot, I nearly had a heart attack. For some strange reason, it gave me palpitations, thinking back to my snow speeder pilots. But look, it's better than a snow speeder pilot. You know, and for its time, I can't even remember when that was done. Copyright 1999. So what's that, guys? Oh, God, I'm getting old. That's around, what are we at? 21 years? Is that 21 years? Oh, gosh. I really need to go out to the paddock. Okay, so there's the pilot. Yes, he's better than a snow speeder pilot. He's actually not that bad, actually. You know, look. I don't like to talk about the movie too much, this particular movie. But look, it's not too bad. You know, if you're a good figure painter, you'll make him look 99%. Maybe, okay, let's go back to 85% fantastic. Here we go. We've got down the bottom here, that's step six. Now, guys, as I was saying to you, look at this. For an AMT kit, whew, look at the amount of parts on this. Engines. Now, whoever designed this kit, or whoever made this model, obviously liked engines. I reckon he was probably a fighter pilot, this guy who designed these, this part, because this is fantastic. And not only that, look at all these lad-ons as well. I mean, struth, you know, strapper for what scale? Who knows what scale? Strapper, what? I don't know. I don't normally build motorbikes, guys, but strapper to me, let's take a guess, 1/20th, 1/24th, something like that. Motorbike body on top of that rocket there. And you've got yourself a pretty cool, without the wheels, of course, a pretty cool rocket bike. That's what I was thinking. No offense to this kit. Again, look at this. More parts. More. It's crazy. And look, again here. I mean, more parts again. I mean, I don't know. Is this a Podracer or just a bloody rocket ship? This is crazy. And here we go over here to this part here. Now, this reminds me of bloody a manta ray, this part. Is it manta ray? Stingray, guys? You know what I'm talking about. I'm not talking about a Corvette, guys. I mean, seriously. It's not that cool. Okay. Decals. Now, I did see a video where some of the decals now, because this kid is like 21 years old. 21 years old. The decals are getting a little bit funny and a bit hard to stick on. So he actually painted these stripes. He painted them. Yeah, painted them. Don't know if I could be bothered doing that. I'm the sort of person to go, effort. I'm going to paint it all red and I'll weather it. And maybe I might put one stripe on. But this, painting all this... I mean, come on, guys. Seriously. It sounds like the G-spot again. The amount of effort I'd have to do. Now, look. Here we go. The windscreen. I've got a funny. The windscreen is some dodgy piece of plastic. I could be wrong. Because I did see a piece of plastic in the kit, which I'll show you in a minute. But that is saying C. C. C? Get it? Anyway. And there's a little... Not the snow speeder pilot. Because he's actually doesn't look like a baked bean. Like the snow speeder pilots do. And again... Down here we have the next part, and look, guys, it looks like a pretty simple kit if you like building rockets. Now, what did amaze me about this kit, and what impressed me also with one of the videos, is you get this base with it, and these wires that actually hold everything up in the air. Now, that is fantastic. You don't get your one dodgy little, you know, piece of stand that holds this up. Do you know why? Because these will fall down. So you need three kind of little wires to hold everything up. There you go, 1, 2, 3. And I'll tell you what, I've got to say, it looks like most of the time on most videos, it does a pretty good job and it looks fantastic. There you go, there's your top elevation and your side elevation. Yep, no front elevation, is there? Now, first things first, guys, I saw a guy on YouTube and he had... You know, the vehicle painted up, and I thought, holy hell, like he had these things. And at first, I thought he'd painted these on. And I was like, that guy is a master, absolute master. And I thought, well, I won't be doing that. So, to my surprise, these were actually decals, which obviously relieved me quite a bit. And all the other stripes are here as well. And as I've said before, on one or two videos, I've seen that these decals are a bit old now, so they didn't seem to come off. I was reading they didn't seem to come off the actual decal card or sheet, whatever, as well as real lights. They end up painting them. So who knows, guys? Who knows what these are going to be like? I don't even know if I'm going to use them or not. But anyway, there they are. Now, you do get this plastic piece, and I don't know what this is for. At first, I thought this was probably going to be for the windscreen part. And it still might be, but I haven't seen a template or anything for it. So, look, I'll let you know when I know, because I'm just doing this review and I've pulled it out of the box and I've gone, what the? So I'm guessing it's the windscreen part, because other than that, at the moment, it's a NFI for me. Here's the base. And again, you've got the nice, whatever you call it, emblem or whatever, that's on the decal sheet as well. So that's quite nice. But I saw a guy on YouTube, I keep on saying this, but this is why I bought this kit. And he actually sort of weathered this up with some rocks and stones on as it were in the desert. And looks absolutely fantastic. Another guy, which is in another video I have down below, had like a backdrop with the rock, like the cliffs from the movie in it. And that looks fantastic as well. And he went and lit his model. And it looks absolutely fantastic. So... I don't know, you know, when you see, sometimes you see a model and you go, nah, it's not for me. And then you see someone else build it. And you just go, wow, I'm going to have to get that now. Anyone else feel like that? Sorry, there's no one else here. There you go, guys. There's the pilot. And look, he's a hell of a lot better than a snowspeeder pilot, an AMT snowspeeder pilot. And the seat's a hell of a lot better as well. And the little gear controls. This here with the little Ys and stuff like that, it just looks, you know, I just wasn't expecting this much detail in this kit. Here we go here. There's your man array there, not your Corvette. And again, that's nice and smooth. And the size of it's quite nice. Actually, for some reason, I thought this kit was a bit smaller. I can't remember the size of someone was saying. I don't know if it was 132 or I can't remember what size it was, something. This is all the engine parts. Now, I haven't found a clear cockpit. Look at the detail on this. Now, there is more detail put into these engines on just a, you know, that part there. I don't know if you can see that. I'm going to zoom in for you. Look at this part here. Now, that as far as all the Star Wars kits that I've seen, that part there, for such a small part, has probably got more detail on it than any other Star Wars kit I've seen. Absolutely packed chockers with little details. And as well as the rockets there. Look at down here. I mean, this puts a, you know, like an X-wing, I don't know what you call it, you know, the wing, the engine part, almost just blows that away. I mean, in thinking about that, you could almost kit bash an X-Wing and use some of these parts. I mean, that would look dead sexy. Mamma mia, I mean, look at that. Holy dooly, so much detail. As I'm going through this, the only thing that's really bugging me about this kit at the moment is, do you get a clear windscreen or not? Before I forget, here's your little steel rods for that holds the actual model up on the base. And this thing here is between the two engines. Here. The only thing I could probably call a boulder dash on is this part here. Now, for whatever reason, I don't think I've got that in my kit other than this here. So this here, to me, looks a lot different to that, especially with that little part there. And I can't see a template anywhere for me to actually use to cut this out to do that. So my kit was sealed, the actual box was sealed, factory sealed, and the kit parts were in there. So I'm guessing they didn't put that part in the kit in the end. Maybe they thought it was too expensive to do that in clear, and that's why they gave you this instead. If you've built it and you have that part, let me know. But other than that, that's probably about the only disappointing part in the actual parts section of the kit. Sure, there'll be a lot of sink marks, some fit issues, I'm guessing, you know, because these are older kits. Not that old, but, you know, old enough. Again, as you know, I like to do a bit of a cross-section of kits on my channel, so I thought this one would be a good one to show off and obviously build. Thanks a lot for watching, guys, and I'll catch you later.